So this is for the person who wants to update their Gigabyte motherboard with all their hardware installed. So like me, I have my CPU, my power supply, my video card there. I need to update my BIOS so I can get a newer CPU on the Ryzen platform AMD. You're gonna need a thumb drive, and you're just gonna plug that thumb drive into any USB port that you have. I'm gonna even put mine right in my USB hub at my desk. Right in there, there we go. So mine just popped up right on the screen. Let's go take a look at that. Here it is right here, thumb drive D. Right click that, and let's go to format. You're gonna hit the format button, and this is gonna delete anything that's on here. And you're gonna wanna format this at FAT32. Now, if you see that NTFS, then all you gotta do is just click this here, click FAT32, and then all you're gonna do is do a format. It's quick format, and then you're just gonna hit start, that's it, boom, start. It's gonna erase everything on there. It's telling you right now, hit okay, and let her format out. It's gonna say format complete, okay, you're good to go. That drive is ready to go now. Now we're gonna head over to the Gigabyte website. Boom. Let's go into products, and we're gonna go into motherboards, and then we're gonna go into different. This is how you find your motherboard. So you might have to either put your chipset or your socket. I'm gonna go chipset for me because I am rocking the X570 chipset. This is my motherboard right over here. This is the Pro Wi-Fi. So we're gonna hit that one. And you might have different revisions, so you gotta know what your motherboard is. It usually says right on the box for that matter. And then we're gonna go down and hit the support, and here on your left you see your BIOSes and all your other drivers, but we're just gonna hit the BIOS, and you're gonna go up to the last one. So this has a lot of BIOS updates, and the last one, because that's gonna give you the latest updates, is the F36A. Okay, so I'm just gonna hit download for that, and there it is. Okay, so we're finished here. Head over to downloads. We'll open this up and extract it, which I've done it before here. So I'm just gonna show you extract. Boom, here it is. We're gonna copy that folder, and we're gonna go right into this drive and paste it in. Boom, there it is. So now it's in that drive. And that's all you really need to worry about at that time. It's in that USB port that we put it in earlier. All you have to do is restart your computer, hit your delete button as you're restarting, and that will take you right into your BIOS. You know, if you screw up the first time, don't worry, restart again and just keep on hitting that delete button, and then it will take you right in. And I'm gonna show you where to go from there. So let's do it. Hit that restart button. I'll see you in the BIOS. And so now that we're in the BIOS, we just go down to Q flash. We're gonna update the BIOS. So click that. And there's our file. You can see it because it says 36A. Just click that file and it sends it right over to the other side. And then you click on that and it pulls the file up and you send it. This says, do you want to update this BIOS? And yes, you do. So you hit yes. All right. So it brings the file in. You can see that on the left, F36A is on the left. And then you'll see above the current flash says F5 BIOS. And then below is the F36A. So basically at this point, we're just going to let this go and update and come back. I'm gonna speed up really quick to 100%, and then your computer is going to reboot itself. So at this point, we're just gonna keep on hitting delete until we get into the BIOS. So we see that, and now keep on hitting delete, delete, and that should get us into the BIOS. As we get into the BIOS and the computer starting up, what we want to do is just double check and make sure everything is looking good. So we see our CPU is at 3600 megahertz. We got our memory, our voltages, everything looks pretty normal at this point. And then we just want to come over here to the left and make sure that we see that BIOS version is the F36A, and we see that. So yay, we succeeded and the BIOS is updated, and we just want to exit this and make sure we're in good shape. Then our computer will restart. So now you should have your new BIOS installed, and I hope you realize it was a lot easier than you were thought it was going to be. And I'm excited too, because now I can update to a new CPU. If you have any questions or comments, please put them down below, and please hit the like if this helped you out. And I hope you guys are having a fantastic day, and I thank you for watching. I'll see you on the next video.